Welcome to the Bourbon Van. I'm Phil.
I'm Julie, and we're trying our first bottle of Texas whiskey. Oh, not too bad.
All right. This is a bottle that we picked up earlier today at Party Stop in Amarillo, Texas, and we were actually recognized there by Cambry, who then directed us to this bottle, helped us find Still Austin, which is exactly what we were looking for there. And as Julie said, this is the first bottle of Texas whiskey that we have purchased. We've had a sample or two sent our way, but it's a little different having a two-ounce sample in the house versus an entire bottle of something like this. And we're really excited because you guys keep asking us, have you tried Texas whiskey yet? What's your favorite Texas whiskey? When in the world are you guys going to try some Texas whiskey? So today we're doing it for the first time.
And while we bought this bottle in Texas, we actually just went over the border to New Mexico. So new state today.
Yeah, and not the
greatest campground.
Not super picturesque. It's free.
It is free. And if you've been following along, free is good.
So this is Still Austin. This is the Musician Straight Bourbon Whiskey, 98.4 proof, and 100% Texas grown grain. We like the sound of that. And it's aged at least 2 years. That's young.
It's young. But we've heard really good things, so I'm excited, and I will say, it smells pretty darn good.
Smells good. This bottle, we bought it, by the way, in the upper 30s. I want to say $37, $38. I think that includes tax. I forgot to get a receipt, so.
We'll find out later.
Find out on the credit card receipt. So we're going to check out the nose, the palate, and finish, and let you know what we think.
It's a very pleasant nose.
Super pleasant. Yeah, this smells great.
It's very bright, like almost citrusy.
Yeah, a light spice there. Probably cinnamon.
I like what I smell.
I like it too. Maybe even some brown sugar. Light brown sugar. A lot of lightness.
Cheers, everyone.
Cheers.
Man, for 2 years, she's pretty good.
And really distinct. That's quite different.
And there's a nice amount of flavors in there. It is very sweet, very caramely, slightly oaky. I think there's a nice hint of cinnamon in there.
You know what I like on this that is probably my favorite part? And it's you haven't actually mentioned this. I'm a little surprised. Maple syrup, maple sugar, like melt in your mouth, brown, maple-y, sugary goodness. I feel like Elf.
I like it. It is kind of candy-like, but like you said, a maple, sugary, cinnamon, candy conglomeration. I'm pretty impressed, actually.
Wow, I like this.
I shouldn't say actually. I'm just pretty impressed.
I'm impressed because for 2 years aged, I didn't expect much.
No.
And I'm more than pleasantly surprised. This is good whiskey.
I like it. As an extramediate bourbon drinker.
Sure.
I think it's great. I think it's really good.
I do too. And we haven't talked about the finish yet, but cinnamon, brown sugar, caramel, maple, all that stuff is still hanging around. This is a very sweet, well-balanced, and flavorful whiskey.
And sometimes with a younger whiskey, you sometimes get that ethanol on the nose and on the palate. And this has just a lovely little heat, considering under 100 proof.
Sure.
And it has a pretty, like, decent finish.
Yeah.
Almost, like, I don't know if I would say long-lasting, but it's, like, at least a medium finish.
I would agree with that. I think that this whiskey over-delivers, both for its proof point, for its price point, and for its age. All across the board, I think that this is a really good whiskey, and this is the only one that they had there. I didn't see any cask strength or anything like that.
Nope.
But this is a very good bottle, in my opinion, especially for under $40. I think that's fair for craft whiskey. And 100% Texas-grown grains. They're doing it right. They're doing their thing at their distillery. And well done, Texas. You've got a great distillery here. And this is the only one that we've got into. Balcones is available in Oregon now, so we will be checking that out in time. We couldn't find any Iron Root.
And unfortunately, we had to kind of hustle through Texas as we're headed on home. But I'm interested in coming back and trying some more options.
Yeah, I'd like to come down here and actually visit some distilleries and check out more, because if this is any indication of what Texas is up to with their whiskey, we are all in for a treat, I think. So well done, Still Austin. Well done, Texas. And thank you for the hospitality. I should thank New Mexico for the hospitality, but I haven't met anybody here yet. But everybody we met in Texas was fantastic, including at Doug's barbecue.
Oh my gosh. And shout out to Doug's barbecue in Amarillo. We stopped there for a late lunch. holy smokes, it was delicious. It was just, it seemed like a little hole in the wall, but man, it was killer.
What a delicious hole in the wall. It was fantastic. So thanks to Doug's and thanks to the Party Stop and to Cambry for helping us dig up this bottle. It was hidden behind some Jim Beam, so on my
sure
first
was.
Pass, I didn't see it. Anyway, saying that you enjoyed our channel made my entire day. So thanks again. And what else?
From wherever we are.
To wherever you are.
Cheers, everyone.
That's tasty.